do this on dry hair because I'm gonna pre-poo. I've already put oil and everything else on my hair overnight. So now I'm just gonna let this sit and saturate my ends. So hair is just saturated with conditioner. So we are all set for wash day. Got my hair with my conditioner on for pre-pooing. Got my waist trainer on to get the waist snatched because, you know, we got some trips coming up. We gotta get it together. And now I'm just gonna continue doing, you know, doing my regular day in the house, and we'll get to this later on today. Okay, honestly, I wanted to record a video of me washing my hair in the shower, but you guys obviously know how to wash your hair, your own hair in the shower. I just really wanted to show you the products that I use, which weren't really anything anyway. Let me. Because what happened was I was supposed to wash my hair like an hour ago, but my baby girl was not wanting to go to sleep and it just kept pushing it back, and I wanted to do a workout before I washed my hair, but that didn't end up happening. So I was just like, you know what, when she finally went to sleep, I was just trying to go fast, and I got literally all my tripods here in the bathroom with me and none of them were working. I tried to put the camera in the shower with me, it kept fogging up. I was like, you know what, forget it, I'm just gonna show them the products, because at this point, this is ghetto. I need to try and get this hair done before baby girl wakes up, at least blow dry. So the only things I use in the shower today, which the last time I used Olaplex and my hair turned out really good. I don't know if this is going to do the same thing, but my hair normally feels really good after I get done using these products. I just use Herbal Essence. This is the Hemp and Potent Aloe, the shampoo and conditioner. So I use that on my hair to wash it and condition it in the shower. And then what I do after I get done on wet hair, I use the Aussie leave-in conditioner. And then I use the Silk Blowout by, who is it by? Organics, I think. Yeah, Silk Blowout is quick drying thermal spray. And then lastly, I don't know if this is how you're supposed to use this, but I do use the Color Wow. I do use the Color Wow product as well on top of all of this stuff. I think on the back it says use it by itself, but whatever. I use those three products before I get to straightening. Oh, I'm sorry, four products. And then I use this as well. This is the combo I use on my hair to get it nice, silky, straight. At least this is what I used when I used the Olaplex the last time. I'll show you guys what numbers that I have, but I just use the shampoo and the conditioner of the Olaplex. And is there anything else? And I think that's pretty much it. So I'm just gonna spray this into my hair. My texture is kind of going back to how it was pre-pregnancy. However, I will say that my curls are a lot more defined. I don't know if you can see. I don't know if I want to grow my hair out again or keep it this length. I really love it this length, but I do have some heat damage pieces in the front because I don't ever wear my hair curly. Although I'm sure it would be cute, it's just some of these pieces are kind of like straight, and I'd probably have to get like a curly cut or something like that to where I would have, it would force me to wear my hair curly. All right, I think I sprayed enough. I kind of went overboard. It's like when you're talking, you're not really paying attention to what you're doing. Okay, and then I do the Aussie. I know this seems like a lot of products, but this is what I use on my hair, and I'm not a hairstylist, so y'all hairstylist people come for me, okay? I'm just doing what I feel works for my hair and what nourishes my hair. Just spray this on. Bang! And then we're gonna spray the Color Wow. And this, low key, this stuff, it looks like just a mist. It barely even has a smell to it. That's what I'm like, what's in here? Make sure my hair is all washed out. Cause you know, sometimes you can wash your hair and still have conditioner or shampoo in it. All right, done with that. And then lastly, I just use the BioSilk Silk Therapy. I just use like a dime of this. Cause you don't wanna put too much cause then your hair will be greasy. Sometimes I use a little bit more because my hair is on a thicker side, but I don't think I actually need it. But yes, so this is what I do before I go in with the blow dryer. I'll show y'all, I think I have my blow dryer, I think it's maybe a red. I don't know, I'll have to look at it. And then I'll show y'all, I think I use H2 Pro flat iron on my hair. And you see my hair, if the front pieces right here weren't so straight, I would wear my hair curly. I would just let do a wash and go. Obviously I need some product on some of these pieces, but I think I could get away with it. It's just, you got some straight pieces here. And low key, I do feel like my hair is starting to do postpartum shed. Ugh, I was dreading it. But so I just go in with this type of brush, and then I bring a water bottle to help with detangling. I try to be really gentle with detangling my hair, so I'll be right back. And of course, as soon as I get done putting the product on my hair, my baby girl wakes up, and then I'm trying to rush and put stuff down, like, whoo. Having kids is a blessing, but it's also very chaotic. Very. So now I'm just going to take my hair. I have her behind me. You gotta do what you gotta do. She's in her lounger thing, and she's drinking her milk. So it's as good as it's gonna get today. Still gonna push through and try and do my hair. I'm just dividing this into, what, three sections? Because I want to start with the back, one side of the back. Oh, God, that hurt. But see, the back of my hair curls so good, but then it's like, yeah, annoying. I think the key to getting my hair so straight is just making sure you get your roots really straight. And then I use a fine tooth comb to go through my ends, but it's the roots. It's the roots that you want to. Oh, and this is also a H2 Pro. Ghetto. H2 Pro blow dryer. Yeah, I just take a section like this. I'll spray the ends because I want to make sure I'm not pulling my hair out and it's not completely dry, because I feel like my hair is hard to comb through when it's completely dry. And then I just take this comb and comb through from root to tip. So, and I just do this for the entire section. I just do it piece by piece. All right, so one side is finished. I'm gonna come back and when the other side is blow dried, but this is how my hair looks blow dried completely through. Roots look really good. Hair feels really good. I think I did a good wash on this one. And then the products that I put in after I shampooed it, making it feel really like it's gonna be a good flat iron job when I get done with it. But I will holla at y'all when I get done with the other side, because I don't want my battery to die. Okay, so we are done blow drying. We got some movement. It's giving the little lady off of what's her name off of The Incredibles? That's what we're giving, but this is us blow dried all the way through. We got some body. I kind of want to push it and see if I can flat iron it with baby girl sitting down here with me, but I might have to do that later. But I'm going to come back to y'all, okay? Okay. Y'all, tell me why it's 10:30. I still have yet to straighten my hair. I'm just now getting in the bathroom. And baby girl is not even asleep yet. I had to leave her in here with her dad. I had to just be like, you look, I gotta go do my hair. Because if I wait any longer, I'm not going to be able to get done. I am so tired right now. I'm so tired. And I honestly just want to snuggle up in bed and go to sleep. But here I am getting ready to flat iron this hair. I finished blow drying hours ago. Now I'm getting ready to spray this on my hair and we're going to get the straightening. This is a thermal heat protectant that I love. I've been using this heat protectant for years, I think since college. Another key to getting my hair really straight is a fine tooth comb. And now we're about to get to flat ironing this. And this is also H2 Pro Silk. I was about to say H2O. I try not to keep the heat any higher than like 375. I'll leave that up to the professionals, okay? But this is how high I have my temperature on mine. I always just get the comb. I do the ends. Ooh, I almost burnt my neck. I do the ends first. And then I just do, I kind of do one pass. Or one and a half. I feel like I need to change the camera to this side, but this is the finished product on this side. Oh. I haven't put anything on it besides the products that I did before I started flat ironing, and it looks pretty good. I feel like second day hair is always better than first day hair because I'm able to wrap it up in my scarf and get it nice and, you know, get the products nice and saturated into my hair. Like, it gets just, I don't know, that's just my science to it. But I try not to do too many concentrated passes on the front pieces because that's where I see most of my heat damage at. But I'm loving the body that this has. Like, now, for the other side. Okay, so I am done. Like I said, I feel like second day hair is always better than first day hair. I don't know what it is. But I did bump it a little bit at the end. Sometimes after I get done doing flat ironing my hair, I like to divide it into halves and then put it in bang two knots. Like, just bang two knots like that. And just let it sit for a little bit and then I'll take them off. Because sometimes that also helps the hair absorb the product, in my opinion. I don't know where I got this from, but it's like a shea butter. I don't know where I got it from. It don't smell that great, but whenever I put this on my hair, the next day, it is like so smooth, like silky smooth. And I'm like obsessed with it. I'm almost out of it. I need to go through my emails and see if I can find the company that I got this from to see if they still sell it. But it feels like a shea butter. Like, it kind of looks like that. I don't know if you can see. I can only use a little bit. And I rub it together because it's kind of thick. And then I really focus on my ends. And then I put a little bit through the roots. Like that. And I don't know what this does, I mean, exactly, or if it's supposed to do this, but that my hair feels so good in the morning time. All right. So that is what I do to get my hair nice and silky. I'll show you guys how it looks in the morning. That's pretty much it. Like I said, I will show y'all the finished product in the morning, but for the most part, she is healthy and ready to go. What's up, y'all? It is Friday, the weekend of New Year, and we are still trying to figure out what the fuck you about to do. I think we're gonna go to Savannah. My family's from Savannah. I think me and my husband and family are gonna go to Savannah and get into some shit, you know? But anyways, it is Friday. It is only 9 o'clock in the morning. I'm taking a break from work, getting ready to wash my face. So I'm gonna do that, and then I'm gonna show y'all how this press came out. Because remember, yesterday I told y'all it's the second day here for me. And it might even be third day hair. I don't know. Because I feel like the last wash, it did take... No, it didn't. It didn't. No, second day. It was second day hair. So, we're going to see what this Herbal Essence and all the other products did to my hair. So, I'm going to be right back. Let's take this off. Okay, so the edges look really good. We flat up there, like that. Now, sometimes when I take this out, because I have the banana clips, I think that's what they're called, in there, they leave like little indentations in my hair, but they fall out throughout the day. So I don't worry about it too much, but just as long as my hair is on flat, at least a little, you know, at least a little bit. Okay, we got, ooh, hey. Look at the body. Come on. Okay, now one side, because I think this side kind of was peekabooing out of my scarf last night. So yeah, this side is much better. Maybe I'll stop seeing you guys over here. I think because this side of my hair was like peekabooing out of my scarf last night, so it doesn't have as much of the indentation, but the hair feels good. Okay, hello. No, but it feels good. It looks good. Yo, I think I'm gonna grow my hair. As much as I really want to cut it again, it's just I love when my hair gets long, but when it is healthy like this, like when it's full of body, like this has so much body to it. What time is it? Yeah, like, get into it. It just looks really good. And then this side, like I said, this is the little indents that you see are from my banana clips that I had in there, but it's laying really good. Really good. Like, I don't like for my hair to be super flat. I like for it to have a little bit of body, not too much body. Like, you're gonna see this thickness, okay? You're gonna see this thickness. Now, I do plan on getting my nails done today before we hit the road. So I'm just gonna do very light makeup. And this is just Glossier concealer. Yeah, I'm probably just gonna put on all over.
The only thing I don't like about driving down to Savannah from Atlanta is the drive. Like, it is very boring because all you're looking at is this road. Like, there's nothing. There's nothing at all. So, and it's 4 hours. That's a lot. So y'all, I went and bought me some new blush because the other blush that I had was really old and is wet and wild. It's wet and wild. And I was just like, you know what? I think I bought this at a hair store. The top is broke. I mean, it's been very faithful to me and it works great. So that's why I was like, I'm not throwing it away, but I was like, you know what? Let me just upgrade to something a little bit more. So I bought the Pat McGrath Labs Divine Blush is what it's called, I guess. Or is it the name of the, it might be the name of, okay, yeah, Divine Blush. And then this one is in Love Struck. Now I will say, when I first tried this on, I dipped my little blush brush in there way too hard because it was like, I put it on, I felt like a clown. Felt like a clown. Packaging is really cute. But then I was like, you know what? Let me try it again. Let me give it another try. Because I know Sephora is really good for allowing you to bring back their products if you don't like it within a certain time frame. But I was like, let me give it another try. And I did. The next time I was a little bit more lighter on the hand. It's very pretty. I was a little lighter on the hand and it was beautiful. I'm gonna just do a little bit. So I just, boop, just a little bit. Now, I will say you do have to work it in a little bit, like bring it up. But you see how pigmented it is? No blush, blush. No blush, blush. Hello? So now I'm just gonna go do the other side too. But yeah, you do have to blend it really good. So I'll give you a nice little sun-kissed look. But I actually do like it. I mean, for the amount of money that I spent on it, it better be good. It better be good. But it's really, I like it. I like it a lot. But I'm gonna keep this. I'm gonna keep it. And then it lasts all night. Like, I wore it the night we went out on the town and it looked so pretty all night. So really good product. I'm still gonna keep my old one though, just in case, you know.
You're gonna see hair came out good, cause you keep me swinging.
I lied. One more thing. I've been telling y'all that I've been using whitening strips. Pidu. I don't know. Amazon, though. Amazon, they come with 28 little strips like this. And I'm not gonna put them back in that jar because that would be insanity. Pidu whitening strips, they come like that and they're really easy to put on. They have a bottom and top row, look like this. This is the bottom, that's the top. And I think you leave them on for like 45 minutes. Yeah, wear 30 to 45 minutes and then remove and discard. So yeah, we're gonna be walking around here. Now let me put some chapstick on. Okay, y'all, for real, this time, I gotta go. Thank you.
We'll pray for you.
Right.
Hey, hon. Stop trying to get me. Trying to get me shot. I'm trying to ignore me over there.
I'm not. That's why she was saying something about congratulations, right?
Oh, yeah.
Like, how you know? That means you've been on this man page.
Dress probably did.
pull up, put a spotlight on.
No!
Pull up.
Mikey's pulling up.
Worry about sweetheart.
Y'all going home?
Hey! Y'all going home? Huh? Don't call her.
Oh.
I ain't gonna call her. She better not call me then, goddamn it.
We going home. Y'all want something to eat?
What's over here?
Huh?
Is there something
I'm
over
here? Right quick. Well, let me delete that number right quick. I did all that
delete.
Shit for nothing.
Delete.
Waste of goddamn time. Shit.
S is up there hooking that shit up.
And she was hooking that shit up. Is a car behind me? I can't see shit.
No, it's no car behind you. Mikey, are you sure you're okay?
I'm good. We be Waffle House, boo.
There you go right there, Mikey.
What's she saying?
Birthday. Y'all ladies be safe now.
I ain't being single.
Cop blockers in the club. Come sit by me all day and just take away shit.
Can't enjoy life like
Mikey
that.
Mikey said you're trying to get away.
Can't enjoy life.
You're like trying
that.
To get away from that girl.
I was trying to get away. I can't even go nowhere.
Shit.
Everybody from the club about to come on right over here to Waffle House.
Club Waffle House. About to take us an hour to get food.
Across the
guys just left me. I could have been kidnapped.
I swear to God, hey.
They got to get dressed.
It's the first car first.
Leave the house.
We're going to be here for at least an hour.
What do you mean, what are we doing? We're waiting. Oh, Jamal, she was going to bring us mingles.
No, help out much you can.
Maybe we'll hopefully we can get some food.
Hopefully, don't get nothing complicated.
Yeah. You said I can't get this crap.
No.
I can't get this. Old. I can't get this.
Get it every day. Drive it tomorrow, man.
Don't get it. I feel my liquor, man. You definitely feel my liquor. Look at baby. Another question. To grow my hair out or cut it? What'd you say?
Shave it.
Huh?
Shave it.
Shave it.
Hey, there's no way I would leave a pregnant girl by herself.
Yeah,
I'm sorry.
That's insane. It literally is.
I would never leave her by herself.
It's literally insane. ASMR.
IHOP.
You're the baker, please go to the back. Are you
okay? What you doing?
He probably isn't gonna answer.
If he answers, I'm gonna be very surprised.
Yeah.
Are you okay?
Are you alright? Where's Mikey?
You dropped Mikey off, man.
Mikey's in the car. Also, Mikey's still in the car?
Oh, my.
Mikey's license is expired. They will definitely check that, bro.
Well, why is this like...
Mikey, they gonna check that, bro. But that's an excuse why you can't come get his car.
Maybe
though.
By the time the food... Well, shoot, he don't even have
his
key.
Oh, so you didn't drop him off. Because we were envisioning, like, Will Smith, Jazzy just, like, jumping out the vehicle. That's what was about to happen. Also, y'all welcome back in IHOP.
Mikey, how is your license expired?
It's 5/15.
On your birthday. That's right.
I check my shit before I go down in the police. Shit, I always look at that license check. I look at the Georgia license thing, put my license number in there, and I check my shit.
Oh,
poor
Alex.
But I'm about to pay it down.
Alex, scoot over.
Yeah,
we
get your new license, Mikey. That's crazy.
I forgot. I forgot, bro. I ain't even got my tags yet.
Wait, Mike. I was just about to ask you that. You need the tag.
What in the world?
You need a sticker.
Come on,
you gotta hurry up,
cause
that's
50.
I can
do that online too.
I'm good. Let me out of my ex, the police,
no. Nah, they definitely gonna check your license.
Hey, listen, the bad thing is we turn in Chili's. There's nobody in Chili's parking lot but the police
and the car
and Alex.
And I busted you turn in Chili's parking lot.
You did that. Yeah, dude, you did
Alex
that.
Probably saw you.
Yeah. Hey, no, ain't no problem about it. We drove right by him and put back in the police car.
You let him know that your license is expired.
No, I checked it. I ain't even talking to nobody.
Somebody came
and
said,
"No, I'm saying because Alex called him. I was wondering if he
caught
him back."
No, we pulled in. Police
right here.
Uh-huh. We pulled in. We did this, and we
tell you.
The moment you walk there asking, hey, can I not be on the drive when I'm with
X? They're going to be like, let me check on you.
They're going to check your license.
Because obviously you tricked
me. It's not even that. It's let's keep talking.
Yeah, yeah, right.
Now
right.
It's not all on you.
Yeah.
Hold on, let me go check the nigga in the car.
Yeah. They what's coming to you, man?
That's what we ain't going to do.
Mikey,
but you
tried, though, brother.
He did try. So it is what it is.
I'm always see before I go. See, that's why I know I ain't drunk.
They let him make a phone call, though.
Any type of thing only.
Hey, was that his only phone call?
I hope he got one more.
Yeah, that was his phone call in the car.
That's what I'm saying. The man said he was in the car.
Oh, so they waiting for somebody to get the car. Okay.
He's still waiting, too.
No. So today is New Year Eve, and we are celebrating at Mikey's house, and we're supposed to make a signature cocktail. It's a contest that we're doing. I think I'm trying to find a little blue bowl. My husband wants to do a Henny drink, so I'm looking for
a bowl.
A Henny mix. But that one, that looks cool too. It might be good. I don't know. We gonna see who got the good drinks to get us lit on New Year's Eve.
It's about to be funny too, cause it's a bunch of mixed drinks.
I'm gonna do that one. So I went with the strawberry margarita. We just did the Jose Cuervo. We had a little triple sec.
No, I'm not cooking anything.
And then I added some berries in here. I know I probably should have just stuck with the strawberry, but. I wanted to make it a little colorful to give it a little razzle dazzle. And I mean, it tastes good. It's pretty strong. So that's the whole purpose of today. For us to, you know, get together, have some fun, celebrate, get a little lit in the process. So yeah, I'm about to pour me a cup because I need to get some of this out of here because I don't want it to spill. I got to transfer to another this house. So, but let's see how this tastes.
We're
we're getting ready to go over to my brother's house. We're gonna go celebrate, have some fun, drink some good drinks, and get a little drunk with the family. But other than that, I made my drink, as you saw. Hopefully people like it. I mean, it's pretty basic. I wanted to do something a little bit more creative, but we kind of last minute went and bought stuff for the drink, so I really didn't put any thought into it. I just made it semi-cute. So we'll see how that goes. I got the margarita. I should have made the gria. I think I should have made the gria, but it is what it is. We just want to get drunk and have fun and go into the new year with family and just a bunch of love. But I'm getting ready to get dressed, and I'll holler at y'all in a little bit, maybe before the new year.
I got drunk in the screen, bro. Baby, give me that mean mouth. Hit that pussy like golf ball. I can do this without y'all. I don't know if I go low, though. I go back to the drop house. Spread that bitch in the belt down. Cashing in and I cash out. Turn that shit to a stash house. I ain't taking no handouts. When they calling, I'm in route. For them niggas, they been down. Blow up back when I'm in town. Is it gonna use the bitch? I don't really got a chance. I'm about to fix. All of my baguette, rocket diamonds on wet. I got water around my neck. I just talk about relax. When I pop my bitch lit, I take my friends. Niggas sending me threats. I done bought a new bitch. I'm protecting my flex. I bought my pack. Been to find my hat. I'm coming over next. I should not like a scene now. I got back on my feet now. I don't see how made it out of the dumb south. And I don't even know how. About to pull me a bend out. I took the top off. I'm dripping like hot sauce. I got drunk in the clean rock. Let me give me that mean mouth. Hit that pussy like I'm pop. I can do this without y'all. I don't know if I got locked out. I go back to the drop house. Spread that bitch in the belt down. Catching it and I cash out. Cash flesh into a stash house. I ain't taking no handout.
What's your drink called?
Mango.
Ooh, mango Hennessy Martini. That sounds good.
That's fresh.
Oh yeah, that's good now.
Can I taste yours?
That's good now. I'm gonna give you your credit.
Look right here. Hold on.
It's
like salt.
What it tastes like, Chris?
Strawberry Henny Margarita.
I drink these all the time.
Okay. A strawberry Henny Margarita.
A strawberry Henny Margarita?
Yeah.
Sean win.
It's me and Jamal.
Wait, let me see.
Hey, no wasting liquor. We got to drink on.
Jason, I didn't make this.
You didn't
taste what you didn't make.
I could dig it. Hey, what's this round of rumor?
What you say? Let me
see. Oh, good.
What you think? I ain't gonna ask Jamal.
I just want to make sure I get one of these before they're gone. Okay, thank you. Excuse me, coming through.
Lemon drop.
Lemon drops. It's beautiful. Beautiful drink.
Y'all definitely got you winning for the presentation award.
Sure.
What you say?
Hey, this is stupid. This is absolutely stupid. We need
to participate.
Hey, I'll tell you what.
It's supposed to be strong.
Y'all can chug that if y'all want to. What
the? Yeah.
So
the drink is called a Rim Runner.
Ooh.
A Rim Runner. That shit cracked. That's strong.
I know exactly. I took a sip.
It's a vacation drink right here.
I told you.
It's a vacation drink right here. It's a vacation drink.
Mikey, what you think? Just don't put them in order. The way you want them. Put them in order.
Okay.
Shoot, that's mine
okay,
too.
Okay, Jamal, your turn.
That's right there. Yeah.
That's yours too. Okay, that's Jamal. Mikey, what's yours?
Mommy. I don't know.
Oh my God!
You drank way too much.
It's so difficult.
The presentation.
Tell Duck on the spoons, we don't take no cards out today, but the Joker. I can't remember.
We got 4 set of 4 somewhere.
Hello?
Come on, you gotta keep going. Don't stop. Don't, Mom, you cannot stop. Happy birthday.
Man, I got this. Buttermilk. Just walked in the door. I'm tired. I'm so tired. But it is 2024. Oh my god. Like, it's 2024 and I'm feeling really good about this year. I don't know about y'all, but I feel real good about this year. I'm just speaking positivity into this year. Financial fluidity, like I need all of it. You know what I mean? Happiness with my family, health, all of that. And I pray that you guys get the same and much, much more. But I'm just really thankful that I made it to 2024. And you know, I have my beautiful kids, my beautiful family, my husband, everybody's healthy. Like, I'm just really, really thankful. Like, that's pretty much it. That's the word. Like, I'm thankful. I'm thankful for everything. But today I'm probably going to finish up my vlog that you guys will probably see hopefully tomorrow, and then work on this one for you guys. But I'm about to go relax because we just drove back and now it's like almost a four hour drive, but it wasn't that bad today. It was like really smooth. Like, today was probably the best ride that we've had coming back from my parents' house in a while. So, but yeah, I just ordered us some food. I'm probably about to just go chill out for a little bit. Oh, I want to show y'all. I know I probably could wait to do this, but I'm really about to get on my fitness kick. Like, I'm ready to make it pop. I ordered me some new workout shoes because I really needed a new pair. It literally just goes with everything. How cute are these? They're gonna go with all my workout clothes. Like, hello. And I'm gonna wear them all the time. And they're so comfortable and lightweight. Like, the box literally felt like there was nothing inside of it. And then you pick them up and super cute. Nike, what's the model on this? I said, what's the model? Like, it's a car. These are V2K run shoes. But they're so lightweight. I'm probably gonna utilize them a lot. I'm doing probably focusing more on weights than HIIT workouts, because I feel like for my body type, I need more weight versus HIIT cardio. So we're gonna see how that works. But hold on guys, I'll be right back. I'm cooking. But yeah, this weekend was great, spending time with my family. Me and my husband, like every time we go down to my mom's house, I feel like we always just are like really lazy lounging around. So we made it a point to express to my brother that we wanted to be outside this weekend, and we were outside like every day of the weekend. So yeah, I need to recover from that. And then yesterday we had a little drink off, and I want to say that the favorite was mine, but I think everybody did a really great job. The drinks were really good. They were super cute. A couple of them, like my mom's, hers was like super cute. And then my cousin and my aunt, they had a really good drink with Henny. But the fellas, like they were the judges, so they gravitated to more so to the Henny drinks. But yeah, we had fun. Yesterday was fun. And it was just really nice to be able to bring it in with my family and not be in a club. Even though next year I kind of want to do something a little bit more fancy, like where I'm getting like dressed and, you know, me and my husband are going out. But it's always hard to do that when you have kids, because like you don't want to leave them out. And I never want to leave my kids out. But next year I wanted to be about mommy and daddy, because it's been a minute since we actually were able to go out on New Year's and enjoy it just us by ourselves. So that'll be a nice switch up. Or if we like really change it up and we're out of the country for New Year, that's fine too with our kids. So I just want to do something different or something we used to do. But yeah, I'm about to go finish cooking for my son. You know, he's picky, just making him a grilled cheese, but I don't want it to burn because I feel like I always burn it. But we're back home.